Good afternoon, everybody. I will try to keep my presentation shorter than scheduled so that we have more time for the debate and some opportunity to have a dinner. I wanted to present to you briefly the conceptual framework we developed in the context of the blueprint and its impact assessment and the different support studies. When addressing the topic of water efficiency, it's important not only to look at the measures and what they can deliver in terms of water saving and what would be the cost and the effectiveness of these measures from an end-of-pipe perspective, but also to look at, first of all, how these measures interlink between themselves in a different planning perspective, and also how they link with the different economic instruments that need to be implemented so that these measures are implemented also in the most cost-effective way. So the blueprint pays a lot of attention to the economic instrument, to the degree of implementation or the failures in the implementation of economic instruments. Here, the basis, of course, is the Water Framework Directive, and in particular the Article 9, which calls for incentive for an efficient allocation of resources, also an appropriate degree of cost recovery, and also brings on the table the equity concerns of the price that different sectors should pay for water, and also different segments, in particular for the in-household, etc. Then we have an important component of this scheme, which is the target setting. So here it's very important that the measures are developed from a catchment perspective and that we bring into the analysis a better knowledge of the actual availability of water resources and the demand from the different sectors by building water balance, and also by defining, as it was already discussed this morning, ecological flow, so that we understand also what is the water which is needed by the environment, and therefore what is the water that is left for economic activity. And then it's very important, and it's something which is recalled in the blueprint, that this quantitative assessment is given much more attention and fully integrated into the next generation of river basin management plans. So in the blueprint, we have water efficiency, one of the three specific objectives through which we would like to ensure sufficient availability of good quality water for sustainable and equitable water use. So increasing water efficiency is one of the three goals, together with increasing the resilience to droughts and floods, and obviously reach a good ecological status. And then you will see in the communication that the concrete policy proposal for action at EU level can be distributed. There are proposals which deal with economic instruments, other proposals that deal with integration, with governance, and also with an improvement of the knowledge base. For the implementation of economic instruments, we start from the current situation. As highlighted in the analysis of the River Basin Management Plan, we have first a certain lack of transparency in the way the prices are defined and on which basis, I mean, which is the knowledge on the cost and the benefits that triggers the different pricing schemes, and this is far to be clear. And on top of that, on the basis also of the information that we got from the plant, it seems that the pricing schemes, which are currently implemented in a lot of European basins, often fail to combine these objectives of efficiency and fairness, which are given by the Water Framework Directive. Therefore, the first proposal, which is in the blueprint, is not any kind of additional regulation. It's also better enforcement of the Water Framework Directive obligations with regard to water pricing and to cost recovery obligations. And then metering, water metering, is a very important element of this enforcement. Then there will be also the development of guidance in the context of the Common Implementation Strategy on trading schemes. And there is also a proposal which is currently being discussed in the context of the multi-annual financial framework of making water pricing and cost recovery an ex-ante condition for receiving EU funds. The second element of the blueprint with regard to water efficiency is the better integration of water efficiency into river basin management. Here also, the tool that has been selected in the context of the blueprint is to develop guidance on water balance, e-flows, and target setting in the context of the common implementation strategy. The objective is to ensure that we have a better integration of quantitative resource management issues into the next river basin management plans. This will be a process also for capacity building in the different member states, in the different river basins, for water accounting, definition of e-flows, and hydroeconomic modeling. We have good examples of practices at river basin level. We are also building a capacity at EU level, together with the EEA and the Joint Research Center. And by putting all these elements together, the idea is that a lot of basins can improve the quality of the assessment of quantitative aspects and feed it into the next river basin management plans. Obviously, this cannot be only a desktop research. It needs to be integrated with the monitoring, the different reporting schemes, the statistics that we have on water, ensuring that we are making the best use of all the information which is already accessible and identify the gaps. So this leads to the third category of proposal, which is on knowledge base. Here, one of the proposals of the blueprint is to build a shared water balance system, so as part of a shared water account system that would give a good idea reference situation with regard to water availability and water demand. Because when we want to map this at EU level and with a consistent perspective, what we can see is that we have a lot of gaps and so white part in the map where we have actually no idea of the water which is available and the water which is demanded by the different sectors, the water used by the different sectors. Then there is the work on ecological flow that we have been discussing this morning. I will not come back on that. We are also building, in the context of the blueprint, a database on measures and on policy instruments, and we want to further develop this database and use it as a tool for case study and for capacity building, so by putting different experiences from the river basin so that we can evaluate different experiences and share what we know about the cost and the effectiveness of the different measures. Other impacts, for instance, on climate change mitigation or biodiversity prevention, protection, and also the applicability, which kind of measure can be useful in a specific context and would be even counterproductive in another. And all these tools also can feed into a set of hydroeconomic models at EU and river basin level. And these models should be used in order to support the cost effectiveness, the cost benefit analysis to be performed in the context of the Water Framework Directive and contribute to some extent to the target setting and the integration into the program of measures of the river basin management plans. Then we have in the blueprint some support to specific water efficiency measures. I mean, this is something that we have identified a couple of areas in which there could be room for support at EU level. First, on water-related products, so in households and buildings, where there could be the support from voluntary schemes such as the Ecolabel or Green Public Procurement, etc. And we will also see in the context of the Eco-Design Directive whether there is a room for the inclusion of taps and shower appliances into the Eco-Design Directive. Then also there is, in the context of the Common Agricultural Policy discussion, current discussions on the conditionality for irrigation project and the rural development. So I will stop here, and we have listed four questions for discussion that will not be discussed in this order. And so I let the floor to Beate for managing this debate. Thank you.